Hi friends, in previous class we have seen about Twitter, how to run Twitter ads, how to do remarketing and conversion tracking using Twitter and all we have seen. In today's class we are going to see how to run ads in LinkedIn. Okay, so let's go for LinkedIn. So LinkedIn is actually a B2B platform, business to business. Usually it is used mainly for recruiting kind of purpose and all. This LinkedIn platform will be having students and working professionals. Okay, they'll be hiring people and all. Okay, you know about all these things. You might be uploading your resumes here or CVs here. Okay, you might be applying for jobs in case of LinkedIn and all. Okay, so when compared to Facebook, LinkedIn is a kind of different platform. In case of Facebook, people come for time pass. Okay, they'll not be serious in case of Facebook, but in case of LinkedIn, people will be serious. And in case of Facebook, you'll be finding some kind of fake profiles also. But in case of LinkedIn, okay, you'll not be having any kind of fake profiles mostly. Okay, why? Because people come here to make up their career, okay, to grow in their career, to get a job, and also no one will create fake profiles or upload fake info here. So LinkedIn is one of the best platforms, but it is a bit costly in case of advertising. I see very rare advertisements nowadays. I'm seeing, guys, today I've seen this is one advertisement promoted kind of thing. Okay, so you can also see ads in this LinkedIn feed. You can also see here sometimes. You can also see in messaging also. Sometimes in case of messaging, you'll also get some kind of offers, like offers or some kind of advertisements in your message boxes also. Okay, so the thing is, be serious here, because the people will be professional. And the second thing is, the leads you get here are very genuine. Okay, the leads you'll be getting here are genuine. In case of Facebook, if you get 20 leads, only 2 or 3 leads will be genuine, because people come there for a time pass. They are not searching for your business and all. But here you can do exact targeting. You can also target a specific person or a specific company. You can, that means you can show ad to a specific person or a specific company also. Okay, and the thing here is, people will be genuine, and the leads you get will be almost genuine. So the cost per lead or the cost you invest for advertising will also be a bit more when compared to other platforms, right? So if you are a kind of education related things, if you're a kind of job advertising related kind of things, this is one of the best platforms, trainings, okay? Like that. So what I say is, choose the platform based on your business or niche. Okay, so if it is Facebook, you can promote some kind of things. If it is Twitter, if your business is kind of high-end business or like this, it is good for that. Okay, so if it is LinkedIn, again, it is a kind of different platform. So based on your business and the services you provide, please choose the platform and decide where you have to promote and all. Right. So in case of Facebook, we created Facebook business page, right? In order to create ads, we must have a Facebook business page. Here also, in case of LinkedIn, okay, we can create a company page. We call it as a company page in case of LinkedIn. Right. So there is no mandatory that we have to have this company page in order to run ads and all. So it will be an additional advantage. We will get some extra options in case of advertising if we have a company page and if we link it with our ads account. Okay, LinkedIn ads account. Right. Let's see how to create this company page and all. So if you see here, go to this work option, these tools. Okay, so scroll down a bit. At the end, you can see create a company page. Please click here. So now it will be asking you whether your business is a small or medium to large, based on your employees, based on the number of employees your company have and all. So showcase page or educational institution and all. Okay, why it is asking like based on employees? Because the people who advertise here mostly have companies. They'll be mainly here to, in order to recruit people or in order to advertise about their vacancies and all. Okay, so right, so I'll choose small business. So please give a name. So I'll give it as Digi Ready, like such. Okay, So this company page already exists since. So I have it already. I owned it. Okay. So website, please give your website name. Right here it will be changing. So now it will be asking for industry, a company details. Okay, what kind of thing you belong to and all. So I'm a bit related to education kind of thing. E-learning, I'll choose e-learning. So company size, what is the company size and all. So at max you can have 200 employees in case of small businesses. Right, I'm saying 2 to 10 employees like such. Company type, what is the company type? So whether it is a public company, self-employed, or government agency, non-profit, or sole proprietorship, privately held partnership, based on the type, choose it. Okay, I'll choose self-employed. So you can also choose a logo, so it will be displayed here. I'll choose some logo. Okay, so let me choose something, guys. When you are going for it, please choose proper one. All right. Okay, so please write some tagline or description about your business. Okay, so you can also get what to write and all. Use your tagline to briefly describe what your company does and all. We provide online digital marketing trainings. Let's you can write about your company. Right, upload complete, and your thing will look like this when people search for it. Okay, so you have to agree to this terms and conditions and click on create page. Okay, so once you create a page, you can link up this page, company page, with your ads account. Okay, LinkedIn ads account and all. Okay, and then you can go for running ads. So if you don't have a page also, company page in LinkedIn also, you can run ads. But the thing is, if you want to go for any extra options and all, it is better to have a company page. Some options you cannot opt if you don't have a company page in case of LinkedIn. That's it, right? So create a page. So sorry, I'm not creating it because I already have a page. Okay, so please try it and create your own page. Right. So if you want to look for your page after you create it, and if you want to look for your page, so simply go for search and search for it. Right. This is my page. I already created it. Okay. So this is how it looks and all. Okay, here background cover pic and all you can edit. Okay, you can also go for writing some posts through your page. You can post things like jobs, you can post about some things like Facebook itself. It is similar to Facebook, you can post each and everything. Okay, so you can also go and deactivate this page. Okay, you can also go and manage admins also, means if you are the only person who are managing this, okay, you can also add people to manage your page. Okay, means you can add your friends or like such. Okay, give their name and all. Okay, you can give their name, they'll be getting a request. Once they accept it, they can also manage your page and all. Okay, so if you are a recruiter, you can also go for posts. Okay, you can also post something about recruiting kind of things and all. So let's close this thing. Okay, this is how your page looks and all. You can also create events and all. Okay, so right, so if you view as a member, how other people look your page and all, like this, so they can see your images, documents or videos or anything if you have posted and all. They can also visit your site. They click here, they'll be navigated to my site. Okay, so it's okay. Right, this is how they look my website and all. They can navigate to your website and see about your business and all. Right, so this is how we can create a company page in LinkedIn. So now let's go and see how to create ads in LinkedIn. So as I said before, so wherever you may run ads, whatever platform it may be, so it has some account structure, LinkedIn ads account structure. So let's go and see it. So this is the LinkedIn ads account structure. Okay, we must have an account. We must have an ads account in LinkedIn. Okay, so the next thing is campaign objective. Okay, so sorry, campaign group. In case of this campaign group, we must choose an objective or goal of our campaign, why we are creating it, whether we want website clicks or page views or what. We have to choose one objective. So in case of campaign level, okay, we'll be choosing the placements, targeting, language kind of thing, audience and all, we'll be choosing here. So next thing is ads, ad level. In case of ad level, we'll be giving some creatives like images or videos or text in order to run the ads. So we can have it max 1,000, okay, 1,000 campaigns in each and every ad group, okay, and we can create 50 ads per each campaign. Okay, so the terminology may differ. So here we might be seeing campaigns, next ad groups, ads and all. But in case of LinkedIn, we'll be having campaign group. Under each campaign group, we will be having campaigns. And next, we'll be having some ads where we give some creatives. So why it is called campaign group? Means we can group campaigns of similar type under it. Okay, if we are running campaigns of similar type, means we have created similar campaigns, like four campaigns we have similar, so we can group it under one campaign group and all. Like that, we can have multiple campaign groups also. Okay, that's why it is known as campaign group. So this is about account structure of LinkedIn. So let's go and see how to run ads and all. So here itself under work, you'll be seeing an option called advertise if you are going to run ads for the first time. Otherwise, if you have did it already, you'll see the option here, advertise. Okay, so I have did it already. So it is showing me here. So let me click on that. So you'll be navigated to LinkedIn campaign manager. Okay, LinkedIn campaign manager where we can run ads. So initially, as we have seen, we must have an account, LinkedIn campaign manager account. See, account level. So I already created one account. So if you want to create one, click on create. So we can change this name and all. You can also choose the country and currency which you want. Okay. So yes, Indian rupee, like that. You can choose whatever things you want. If you have any company page, please link it. Okay. So if you type something, it will show you up. So like this, it will show you up. Right. Like this. So if you have a company page, link it up here. Next. So if you don't have any page, LinkedIn page or LinkedIn company page, you can create from here itself. After giving all of the details, please click on save. Okay. Like this, you can create multiple accounts. After you have an account, we'll be going to create campaign group. So I'll be going with the existing account itself. So now, let me create one campaign group. Okay. So campaign group name. Okay. So give one campaign group name, status. Okay. Whether you want it to be in draft state or active state. So run continuously from start date. Okay. You can also schedule when you want the campaigns under campaign group to run and all. Okay. You can also set a start and end date. Okay, set a start and end date with the budget. You can do either of the things. Okay, so Indian rupees, start date, end date, and you can also set up a budget here. Okay, like that, you can create a campaign group. Multiple campaign groups you can create. And if you have any similar campaigns, okay, you can create one campaign group, and under that, you can go for creating campaigns and all. Okay, so that the similar campaigns can be grouped under one campaign group. I think you people are following. So I'll go with this default.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, I'll go with the existing campaign group itself. Okay. No need to create again. Right. So you can create 1,000 campaigns, right? So I'm going with this campaign group itself. So let me create a campaign. Okay. Next campaign group. So you said different group or create new group. I'll go with the new group. This one itself. Group campaigns based on what's important to you. So you can group campaign based on the project, location, budget. Okay. So keep them organized. Right. Next. So I'll be going with the same campaign group. I've created only default campaign group. I'm going with that one only. Now, again, you know about all these things: awareness, consideration, and conversion. Okay, in case of object level, you will be having three objectives. Under them, you'll be seeing various goals. So brand awareness. I want more people to learn about my business. Means if you want to create a brand awareness about your business among people, then you can go for brand awareness. Next thing is website visits, which means if you want to drive people to your website. Okay, I want more people to visit a website destination site on or off LinkedIn. Okay, drive traffic to your website, drive traffic to landing pages on the, okay. So you can go for this website visits. Next thing is engagement. If you want people to engage with your ad, like, share, okay. I want more people to engage with my content posts. So increase social engagement. Engagement means likes, clicks, shares, okay, comments, all these come under engagement. Video views. If you have a video and if you want more views, I want people to watch my videos, okay. So share your videos with more people, then you can go for this thing. Conversions, lead generation, okay. I want more quality leads on LinkedIn, okay. Lead generation means you'll be displayed with a form. You means here the people who click on your ad will be displayed with a form. Okay. So, and here it is saying that, okay, see the second line, here it is saying use the lead generation form pre-filled with LinkedIn profile data. The one who is filling the the one who is displayed with the form. Okay. The form will be filled with already the details of that particular person, it seems. Okay. How it is getting? From their profile. Already they might have given some details in the profile, right? From the profile itself, it will be filling some details. They can edit it so that you can get the details of people. Next thing is website conversions. So if you want people to go to your website and make some conversion or make a valuable action like downloading, purchasing, registration, whatever it may be, you can go for website conversions. Okay, next thing is job applicants. This is an extra option here. You can see this only in case of LinkedIn. Why? Because it is mainly meant for recruiting purpose, as we said. So here, if you want to promote any kind of job opportunities in your company, okay, so then you can go for these job applicants. Okay, so if you want to hire people more fast, okay, if you want urgent recruitments or urgent requirement, if your company is having an urgent requirement, you can go for this job applicants kind of thing and you can run ads about it also. Right, so let me choose one objective, then only I can go further. I'll choose website visits because I have a website. Right, so audience, go for creating a new one. So when you will see the saved audience, after you create any audience and save it, okay, so you can use those audiences when you are running other ads also. See, I have run some ads already. From the saved audience, you can see. Okay, sometimes some kind of audience lives here. Okay, so when you are running ads, simply you can go for this kind of targeting and then you can run ads. No need to set up targeting again and all. So about this LinkedIn audiences and all, okay, I'll say later. So if you want to target these kind of people and all, you can go and directly choose this. Okay, members with the bachelor degree and all. Okay, so another thing you have to remember is in case of LinkedIn, it will be having huge information about you because you'll be uploading your resumes, you'll be giving each and every detail like your date of birth, when you have joined that particular company, currently whether you are working or not, okay, which things you are interested in, which kind of jobs you are looking for, everything, bit to bit, every detail will be true and it is perfect. So the targeting will also be perfect in case of LinkedIn. So where is your target audience? So you can choose one location where you want to target and all. So recent or permanent location or permanent location. Okay, people who visited recently that particular place, a permanent location of that place. So obviously this thing also people will be filling. Currently where you are present and what is your permanent location. Everything that people will be giving. So you can exclude or include also locations. So I'll include location like Hyderabad. Hyderabad, Telangana, India, right? I don't want this thing. You can go for choosing multiple places. Yes, right? I'll be choosing these two places. Okay. So if you want to exclude, if you don't want to show ads to people who are present in any particular locations, you can go for this thing also. The procedure will be similar. So I'm okay with including. Next thing is you can go with the language, okay, targeting. So I'll go with English. So your audience has their profile language set to. So we'll be targeting people who set their profile language to English, okay. So who is your target audience? So you can narrow or exclude people, right? So narrow. Yeah, you can target people based on many things. So these audiences will be mostly helpful for retargeting kind of things and all. I'll be going for audience attributes. Okay, so here you can target people based on the company they work. Okay, means again, in every company, you'll be having many categories, see, company category, company connections and all. So if you hover here, it will say, okay, reach members based on the category their company falls into. What kind of categories their company fall into and all. So, right. So if you click here, you can see. So if you want to target people who are working in this kind of Fortune 100 companies or like such, okay, if you want to target companies, okay, Fortune 1000 only, Fortune 500 only, you can choose whatever thing you want. So next, come back. Company connections means, okay, first degree connections of employees at the companies you select. So if you want to target employees of a specific company, so while uploading your resume and all, you'll be giving where you are working and all also. Your position there, how many years of experience you have there and all will be given. It will also be taken into consideration. So company connections. So I want to target people who are working in Accenture or Cognizant and all. You can also go for Accenture India, Accenture Brazil, you can go. Your opinions again. You can choose multiple company connections. So now my ad will be shown to people who are working in Accenture India. So company follower of, okay, reach followers of your company page, okay? So I have a company page, right? So if you want to show your ad to people who are following your page also, then you can go for this company follower of option. So you can choose this option only when you have a company page, and you must link your company page with your ads account. So in order to enable some kind of targeting on under, you must have a company page in case of LinkedIn, right? So I have only one page. It is displaying that thing only, right? Back. So company growth rate. Okay. So reach members based on the year over year employee growth means, well, how is the growth rate of the company and how many employees it is increasing on yearly basis, like such 0 to 3% company growth. I don't know much about those things. Company industries. So which industry your company must be related to? Designing, education, entertainment, and all, you can choose. So software and IT services. Again, under it, you'll be having many options. Computer and network security, computer software, internet, you can choose multiple options. Okay, so you can go for real estate and all, you can go for beauty kind of things and all, you can go. So company names, okay, reach members based on the organization member has listed as their employer. Okay, company names. So people who are working in Google, Microsoft, Coca-Cola, you can target them. So again, Microsoft startups, Microsoft mechanics, you can choose. All right. So company size, how many employees a company should have? You can choose 2 to 10 employees, minimum company size and all. Like this, you can choose. Next thing is demographics, means age and gender. Okay, age. So you have to accept these terms and conditions. So what should be the age? Here also you can't go for a specific age like 21 to 24 like that. You should choose a range. So 25 to 34 like that, I'll go with this. And next, gender. So the people must be male and female. I'm okay with both. Yes, gender, male and female. I'm okay with both. So next thing is education. What must be their educational background and all, and field of study you can choose. So people will be giving every info, which school they have studied, how many years they have studied, when they are passed out, every detail, pin to pin, LinkedIn will be having. So degrees. So they must have a bachelor degree. You can also go for BSc, MBA, Master of Business Administration and all. master's degree if you want, you can go for it. Field of study, in which field I must have studied? So economics, social, I'll go with marketing and computer science. Marketing. You can also target people based on their roles and all. I'll show you. So in which roles they are working and all, you can choose. So member schools. So in which school they must have studied and all, you can choose. I don't know whether this school is present. Yes, it is also present, guys. Very good. Okay, so the thing here is the targeting will be very narrower. We can make it very narrower. Job experience, okay? Job functions, what should be their role, okay? So common tasks or activities, what should be their position and what should be their role in the company? Under accounting, consulting, education, say business, development, okay? So you can choose based on their job roles also. You can also choose based on their seniorities, paid, unpaid, training, entry level. So anyway, managers will not opt for my course and also I'll not be choosing it. So like that, you have to think based on your business and services you are advertising. You have to think, okay? So to whom you want to show your ad and all. So like trainer, entry, unpaid, yes, and entry level also. I want to show my ad. Job titles. So what should be the job title and all? Executive. So it will be showing some suggestions also. You can choose anything. So next thing is member skills. So you'll be also giving some skills while creating your LinkedIn profile, like I'm good at Excel, I'm good at Microsoft Word, like such. Okay, so based on the skills also you can target them. So they must have good knowledge in Microsoft Excel, Microsoft Office. Okay, you can go for it. On the marketing kind of things. Okay, based on these skills also, you can choose them. Next thing is years of experience. So it has changed. Nice. So from 1 year to how many years of experience they must have? So 1 year. So 1 year to 2 years. Right. So based on the experience also, you can show them ads. Next thing, here comes the interests. Okay, interests and traits. Based on their indirect, direct or inferred interest, trials or professional groups they belong to. So which groups they should belong to? They should belong to like marketing groups or business related groups. Okay, so you can choose them. So there will be a huge number of options. Please go and select. Member interest, what things they should be interested in? They should be interested in business and management. So again, business and management, there are various things if you see. Okay, so business administration and all. Okay, business ethics, business technology, see, huge, huge number of options. Why? You can go over greater narrowing targeting in case of LinkedIn. But this much of narrowing targeting, you cannot go for other platforms. Why? Because LinkedIn will be having all your pin-to-pin details. Okay, so you can target specific person or specific people whom you want to show your ads and all. Right, let me go back now. So interest and traits, member traits, okay, career changes, who want to change their career. So job seekers, I want to show who are open to education, open to relocation. Okay, like that you can show your ads. Domestic or international process again. Okay, so like this, you can show your ads to each and every people. See, all your targeting will be shown here. Okay, you can also remove some kind of attributes. If you want to remove all, you can go for it. You can close it also. Okay. So like this, you can see all your targeting and all, right? So you can also exclude some people. As I said, the procedure will be similar again. You can exclude if you don't want to show your ad to this specific kind of people, you can go for again choosing this targeting and all. So I'm okay with including. So if I'm choosing these people, means I'm saying LinkedIn that to show ads to only these people, then again, why, what is the reason for excluding? No need, I think. So, okay, you can also save this audience as a template, save as new audience. I'll save it as 11/1 November or 11/1 December. You can also give a description. It's for your reference. So once you save this thing, you can see this audience under saved audiences. So if you are creating same campaign like this, no need to select all this targeting and all again. You can simply go for saved audiences. You can choose this targeting. Your time. Okay, there'll be no waste of time. You can save some time. Right. your audience has been saved successfully. Thank you. Okay, you can also reset. Okay, so if you don't want this targeting at all, you can reset it again. You can go for it. Okay, view audience summary means it will show you whom the people whom all you have targeted and all. You get a summary. Next thing, it is asking for ad format. How you want your ad to look like? Okay, whether it should be a single ad or whether it should be a carousel. Carousel means slider. You know. Okay, if you hover here, it is saying. Okay, so whether it should be a video ad. So video that will show up in news feed. Next thing is a text ad. Okay, that will show up in right column. Okay, so here it will show up on the right column. Let me go to LinkedIn. So on the right column, you might see some ads. So there'll be some promoted kind of things here also. You'll see such kind of ads on right column or top of the page on LinkedIn. Spotlight ad. Okay, that are personalized using profile data will promote an offering throughout the desktop. They'll be shown throughout the desktop, it seems. Right. The next thing is a message ad. Okay, so these messages, these kind of message ads are delivered to your LinkedIn messaging box. You might see some kind of ads in your message box also sometimes. You'll see direct ads. Okay, which means you'll get an ad in the form of a message. You can send it. Next thing is conversation ads. These ads are also delivered to your target box. Okay, but the thing is you can chat. Okay, so if you might have seen chatbot or like such, right? So in case of chatbot, if you give one question, okay, if you ask for something, you'll get an automated reply, right? So like that, you can create a machine learning kind of thing and all. Okay, you can chat with it. You can ask your questions and you can get answers in return. Like that, you can create a conversational kind of ad, which is sent to your, okay, message box. It will be sent to your message box and all. So in case of message ad, it will be directly delivered to your inbox. That's it. So in case of conversation ad, okay, here, so you can, customer can choose options like chatbot. You have seen that they can choose options and all. Okay, so the spotlight ad is kind of dynamic ad. You can automatically create an ad. Okay, based on the user's profile, it will create an ad and it will show to them. Okay, so choose one thing. I'll go for single image ad. Right, so where you want to place these ads and all, where you want to show these ads, LinkedIn audience network, reach up to 25% more of your target audience means, so if you want your ad to reach more and more people, or if you want to show your ad to more people, then you can go for this LinkedIn kind of thing, enable the LinkedIn audience network also. Okay, you can also exclude some categories. Okay, like mobile sites and mobile apps and sites, you can exclude these things. Okay, if you don't want your ads to appear in this kind of apps and sites, you can exclude them. So I don't want to show my things in this automotive related kind of things and all, you can choose. And next thing is, you can also upload a block list. Okay, means if you have a list of sites and apps which you don't want to show your ads and all, you can go for it. Okay, so you can go for either this thing or that thing. Right, so that's it. There are many options, you can exclude it, hide this thing. Next thing is budget and schedule. Okay, you can set up a daily budget or total budget also, or you can go for a lifetime budget, or you can set both diary and lifetime budget. Lifetime budget means the total amount you want to spend for the entire campaign. So I'll go with both. So if you give some 1,000 rupees per day, let's think that I want to spend 1,000 rupees per day, then obviously you'll be spending some 30,000 rupees per month. Okay. So if you are running an ad for only 3 days, you'll be spending 3,000 rupees. Okay, it is your lifetime budget. So actual amount spent daily may vary, as it is similar to Google Ads. Okay. So in case of daily budget, so LinkedIn may take less than the amount of your daily budget, or equal to your daily budget, or more than your daily budget also, but it will not exceed your lifetime budget. Okay, so some days it might charge you less, some days it may charge you more, but it will not, on whole, it will not exceed this 3000 rupees. So I discussed about it in clear in case of Google Ads. So when your ads have more opportunities to get results, you may spend more than your daily budget. You'll spend up to 50% more on some days and less on others, but will always aim to spend within the range of your 1,000 rupees. So like this, it is saying. But the thing is, your daily budget may exceed. Okay, it may go up to 50% extra, or it may be less, or it may be equal, but it will not exceed your total lifetime budget. In brief, it is saying. Okay, so you can also schedule when you want to start your ads and all, you can choose. Okay, so your campaign will run continuously starting from December 1st. Okay, until we deplete your lifetime budget, until your lifetime budget exceeds, your thing will be running. So you'll spend more than 3,000 in total. You'll spend no more than, okay, 3,000 rupees. You'll not exceed more than this amount. Next thing is bidding. This is a new feature, it seems. Okay, introducing a bidding interface. You are experiencing the new bidding interface simplified, right? So optimization goal, simply, okay, the type of bid strategy you want. Okay, landing page clicks. Why it has given me this? Because I've chosen my option as, okay, website clicks, right? Website visits I have chosen as my goal objective. That's why it is showing me landing page clicks. If someone clicks on my ad, they'll directly navigate to my website. So you can also change this. So, or impressions, you can also go for impressions. So again, based on the goal you have chosen in the campaign type, means based on the objective you choose, your bidding and bidding strategy will also change. You can also go for impressions as well as landing page clicks. Deliver ads to members most likely to click on the link to your landing page. Impressions means deliver as many impressions as possible. Okay, it will charge an amount. Okay, per 1,000 impressions, how much you want to pay, like that, it will ask. Okay, so I'll go for landing page clicks. So see, the bidding strategies are differing when you see. So the bidding strategy is maximum delivery. It is automated bidding strategy, which means, okay, so LinkedIn itself automatically sets bids, okay, in order to get most results. It is an automated bidding strategy. So to help you get most results possible while utilizing your full budget. In case of target cost, okay, we can set an amount. So per click, I'll be spending this much of amount. See, it is saying 220 rupees per click. See, that's why I'm saying LinkedIn is a bit costly, but you'll get genuine leads. I'll assure you that. Okay, get the most results possible while staying near your cost goal. So we can set a amount like I'll pay 15 rupees per click, like that you can say. See, your cost must be at least 60 rupees per click, it seems. Okay, so that's why it is a bit costly per click. Per each click, you'll be spending 60.55 rupees. Like such, you will be spending, I'll be 61 rupees. Okay, but they are recommending 220 rupees, it seems. Okay, similar advertisers are spending 157 to 372 per landing click, it seems. It is saying how much they are spending also. Okay, so and if you go for impressions, it will say again, okay? So for 1,000 impressions, how much you want to spend? Okay, it must be at least 186 rupees per spending. Okay, and you'll be going for manual bidding. We'll only define the amount, bid amount, how much you want to spend for 1,000 impressions and all. So again, as I said, based on the strategy you choose, okay, everything will change, right? So additional options, you can also go for manual bidding here. So 61 rupees per landing click. Anyway, enable bid adjustment for high value clicks. Okay, so by checking this, we automatically adjust your bid up to 35% higher so that you are more likely to get clicks, it seems. Okay, so they'll only adjust your bids to 35% higher in order to get more clicks, it seems. Okay, so you can go with any of these options. I'll go with target cost, right? So next thing is conversion tracking. So I'll say about this conversion tracking and retargeting later. Okay, so I don't need any kind of conversion tracking and all. If you have already set up the conversion tracking code in your website and all, while creating the campaign itself, you can set up conversion tracking also. Which things you want to track and all, you can set up here itself. But later I'll discuss. Okay, so I'll go in a serial manner. So click on next. So confirm save. So once you save, so cannot be changed. See, your objective and ad format cannot be changed once you save. So check once and save it. check twice also. Okay, so your objective and your ad format cannot be changed. Means if you want to show single image or carousel like that, you can't change the top format, ad format. And also objective means landing page clicks or website clicks. You can't change it. Yes, I want to save it. Campaign saved, right? Now it's the time for ads. We have to give some sponsored content. We have to give an image. Okay, you can also go for existing content. If you have created any ads already, you can go and choose them, or else you can create your own content. So click on here, guys. Don't go for back. Okay, click here if you want to close this thing. So you can also create a new ad, which means, okay, you have to give your own things, own image and all you have to upload, or else you can go for existing content also, which means you can choose one thing. If you have run already ads or like this, you can choose from those things. So digi-ready introductory text. So give proper text. You can write up to 600 characters, it seems. Learn digital marketing and promote your business online. Right. So you have to give a destination URL also. Okay, it is mandatory. Why? Because if people clicks on your ad, they'll be navigated to this particular URL. Okay, what is this scrape? Scraping will transfer the image and text from this URL to your ad. Okay, you can also manually adjust the image or text. You can manually adjust them, or else you can, scraping will transfer the image and text from this URL to your ad. So if my website, okay, in this URL, if my website has any images and all, it will only automatically take, it seems. Okay, see, it took already something. Marketing is essential for any business. It is no established marketing. Okay, there is no established marketing. It took some content from my website. It only reads my website, and it will only take some content and images from my site if I have any, if that website has any. So upload one image. So I'll upload something else. If you are going with this thing, go for proper things and all. Okay, it only took headline, description and all. Good. Okay, this is how your ad looks. So you have to add some call to action. Call to action. So download, sign up. I'll go for register. Okay, so add to campaign. Click on create. So that's it. Your ad got added. Okay, so click on next. Now, so it will show you up a review and all. Okay, you can review all these things, targeting and all once, and they can budget and all. Then you can simply go and launch your campaign. So here you can see targeting audience size also. Okay, how many people your ad may reach. Okay, 30 days spend, how much amount you may spend in 30 days, 30 day impressions. Okay, click through rate, how many 30 day clicks you may get and all. You'll be getting some info here. You can see it, right? So click on launch campaign. So now, so you can also go on that payment methods and all. I'll show you. If you want to create another campaign, you can go for creating another campaign also. It's okay. I'll go with account overview. So if you refresh once, you can see it, I think. Yes. Guys, this is the one I created. I think if I were to give a proper name and all, it's okay, right? December 1st, 2020, this is the one I have created. You can keep it in either active state or else you can pause it also. Okay, so account is on hold status like that. You can pause it. You can also click here and you can either duplicate it. Duplicate means copy. You can manage these things and create a chart and all. You can do all these things. So if you want to go for billing and all, so here under your name, okay, go here. You'll be shown with your account ID and all. You can edit your account details and all. You can go to billing center and give your funding sources, payment method. You can add payment methods. You can add credit card like such, and you can make your payment. If we have already made any kind of payments, so you can see that billing activity also. Okay, so you can also give manage access, means if you want to give access to your ads account, okay, campaign, LinkedIn campaign manager. If you want to give access to LinkedIn campaign manager to other people, you can go for manage access and you can add people. You are the owner and admin, right? So you can also give permissions to other people. Edit, Okay, so account manager, you can change the roles, I think. Okay, you add user account and you can give the LinkedIn profile URL here. Their LinkedIn profile URL, they'll be getting a request. Once they accept, they can also manage your ads account or not. Like this, you can give access also. So next thing is manage sponsored messaging things and all business manager request. Okay. You can see all the notifications. Once you spend everything, you can see the notification also. So if you go for this lead generation forms, if you run any kind of lead generation campaigns, you can see all the details here. If anyone fills your form and all your details, all the details will be displayed here. You can download these things also. You can create a form here. You can run lead generation campaigns also. We can download the leads here also. Okay. So this is all about inside tag and all about conversion tracking and retargeting. You can go for website demographics and all. I'll say about these things later. So that's about today's class.